ashamed of, and I'm not.
Hold on, hold on.
Okay, guys, let's, that's not what this is about. Let's stop this. Come on, what are we doing here? What are we doing? Thank you so much.
Mia, how do you feel about the thing that Twitch has become a retirement home for porn stars?
Has it?
Mia's not retired.
They're coming in hard. They're coming in fucking hard.
Oh, people come hard in them, Canoe.
Okay.
Well, maybe they realized a good thing when they see it.
Shout out Fleshlight.
Blowjobs.
Okay, all right. Well, I owe people a lot of things. This is why you guys have to remind me of things, okay? I'm very forgetful.
You tell us to remind your producers, and our producers tell us to fuck off.
Okay, look, all right. That's not true.
Yeah, that's the spirit, cutie.
Yeah, that's what burst happened last out. Time, huh?
Yeah, games and gains. Maybe you could show them all, prove them all wrong, and win the whole damn thing.
If I gotta do it again, I'll do it again.
Okay, all right, best.
Do it again? Have you done it before?
Excuse me?
Not here.
No, okay. He.
Then where? Your local like shitty comedy club?
The local Real podcast.
How did you win?
One of the politics streamers that Knut loves so much.
Ava, do they have cool, like,
what is intersexual feminism, Knut?
Yeah.
We've never even heard of it.
Intersectional feminism, Knut, means I also care about racism and trans rights.
Oh, he doesn't.
Oh.
Knut doesn't even care about.
All right, Wes, come on, like, come on, Knut. Knut, come on. Knut, keep it together, Knut.
She just gave me a jab.
Okay. All
right. Right on the chin.
All right.
Speaking of on the chin, Mia Malkova. Oh,
yeah. Okay. All right, guys. Come on. Calm it down now.
That's really much. I'm
greedy, yeah, really ruthless. Ruthless.
No.
That's what it is. An asshole. Just literally fucking us all over.
Dude,
okay. Okay, guys. How much do we get paid? How much do we get paid for being on this show? He's earning millions of dollars.
Okay, it's first of all, hold on. Hold on. Canute.
No, and he even owes a lot of us money. Canute. He doesn't even pay it.
Canute, it's not millions, it's billions, okay? Forget it right. Yeah.
No, you're trying to make
it
a joke.
No, is it a joke now?
It's
is it a joke what
true.
You did?
Yeah, I didn't do anything.
Wes, we all know it's silly.
Hold on.
No, hold on. I can't have
silly,
this, like, online.
Wait, Wes, if you didn't do anything, why did you just brag about it again for the fourth time?
Kissing you on the cheek is sexual assault.
No, on the lip.
Wait, John,
really?
I kiss you on the cheek.
Why are you sweating right now, Wes?
Wait, what is going on?
What are you doing?
Imagine if Wes kissed John on the cheek.
When you brag about sexual assault like that and Raj defends you, what the fuck?
Zerka, I'll
wait. I don't know what you're talking about, John.
I'm so confused.
Oh, you know what I'm talking about, Raj.
No, we don't.
Oh, yes, you do.
You know, I don't think Wes has.
No. Wes, why don't you brag about it again?
Like I have never committed sexual assault on anyone in my life.
Okay.
Dude. That's not a funny thing to
joke
about.
Yeah, let's stop.
No,
let's stop this because I don't know what he's talking about.
Pretty cringe, dude.
Oh, you know.
Let's move on to a different topic.
Say it then. No. Say it, you fucking bitch.
You just did.
Kissing someone on the cheek. Say that I sexually assault you when I kiss
you
on the cheek.
Yes, you do it without people
then
wanting you to do it.
Then you're a fucking
idiot. You know what? Stuff
this is,
like
this
is
a really bold.
No. Nobody invites that behavior.
Hold on. We're done. Hey, let's move on. Hold on, John. Let's move on. I don't know what you're talking about. What you're trying to do here.
He mentioned it.
This is some good-ass content right now, dude. Let him go.
Say it. Say it.
He was kissed by Wes on the cheek against his will.
This is not a...
Against his will.
If you're serious about it, that's one thing, John. But if you're joking about it, that's a completely different thing.
Interesting topic alert. Here comes Raj to shut it down.
Go ahead.
Look at your DGG, Destiny. They're telling me to shut it down. DGG is telling me to shut it down and move on, okay?
No. Hold on.
Don't listen to DGG.
I'm a puppet for DGG, all
right? Zerka, I will tell you right now that if you want to play this game, I will expose you for shit that you're ashamed of, and I'm not.
Hold on.
Okay, guys, that's not what this is about. Let's stop this. Come on, what are we doing here? What are we doing?
Lash your boss.
This
what
is
the
fuck, Slicker. What are you
say
doing here?
Say it one more time, Zerka.
Raj, can
Zerka,
I?
Zerka, I'm daring you, little
Raj,
bitch.
What the hell are you doing,
I'll
Zerka?
I'll drop the fucking fire on you, boy.
No, hold on.
Say
on,
it.
Raj.
Call me a sexual assaulter one more
dude,
time.
Let's stop this. Wait. What are we doing? What are you doing, man? What's going on?
Call it.
Sexual
assaulter. Call it, Zerka. I'll fucking drop fire on you right now.
Zerka, you're a bouncer, dude.
You don't have the fucking balls to say it because you know it's false.
Wes, joke about it again.
Say it. Tell me I'm a. Tell me I sexually assaulted you. Say it.
Joke about what you joked
fire.
About on stream just now.
What?
Say it. Just I'm asking you to say it,
you
and
said,
I will fucking
you
tell me I sexually assaulted you.
You just joked about it.
Say
how
it,
you come
say
up,
it. Just say the words, Zerka. I'll fucking end you right now.
Let's stop. Hey, guys.
An eye for an eye makes the whole world blind.
Yes,
guys.
Thank you. Mohandas K. Gandhi. Thank you, me.
Surprising answers that guys wouldn't expect to hear. Like, you could, like, there are a surprising number of really hot girls that'll say things like, oh, like, I think dad bods are cute. But if you talk to guys, some guys can weigh like 250 pounds. Will be saying shit like, I don't know, I would never fuck with a chick that's like 120 pounds. She's like that have like very high standards. And it's like, okay, dude, like you should be a little bit more realistic and like the type of people that you're trying to associate
I'm
with.
I'm more than 250 pound destiny.
That's what I would say. So true, yeah.
I mean, you're
only I'm more than 250 pound destiny and I wouldn't fucking sleep with a girl 120 pounds. So.
Sure.
120 is not okay, where even close.
I also think as women, like as women are raised, there is a higher chance of like women being insecure and guys have inflated confidence more often than not. And so I think like guys often consider themselves like, oh, I'm an eight. Like I should be able to date eights when in reality they're actually a six and they shouldn't be shooting that high. You know what I'm saying?
I think it's quite the opposite because
but wait, they meet in
like
the middle.
Tinder and Bumble, women have it far easier on those apps and it creates a mode of confidence that they actually is in reality, they're not that good looking.
Kim's again, it's far easier in what sense that they could get any dick they wanted? Of course they could. Every guy's a horn dog.
Like a guy on Tinder and on Bumble is going to have a much harder time than a female because a guy has to lower the standards and a female just can get anybody they want.
We're not talking about Tinder or Bumble though. We're talking about like real life interaction.
Yeah,
but like on Tinder and Bumble, if you're literally just looking for somebody to fuck.
I use that as an example, you dickhead. All right.
Hold on. Hold on. Hold on.
More to attraction than just your.
Hold on. Hold on. 1 second.
Excuse me.
We are talking about a real-world example here about women, actually the exact opposite of what they're talking about. Women actually now have far too much confidence because of those apps. And that trend...
What? What? All right, okay, all right, hold on. Hold on, 1 second. 1 second. Let's have one of the females... Let's have one of the females respond. Cutie, yes, go ahead.
Yeah, okay. So let's talk about social media in general. If you're going to talk about apps, think about all the pressure that girls have now because of the pictures that other girls are posting on Bumble and Tinder that are filtered and edited and yada, yada, yada that all of us expect
just edit
is
them then.
No, that's absolutely not true. Women don't have more confidence. Women are more insecure than ever because we're having these beautiful women shoved in our face all the time. Every day.
That wasn't even the case.
Hold on.
You can still get laid like this.
Yeah, with men and women.
Just because you have a bigger pool of people who will fuck you doesn't mean that it's easier, like, to find someone at your level. What?
Yeah.
Like, if you're an eight as a girl, yes, everyone 7 to 1 will DM you trying to fuck you because men have inflated confidence and we think we can fuck anyone. But that doesn't mean that it's easy to find someone that's like your level, dude.
I don't know. I think it's important to clarify. There's a huge difference.
Hold on, Destiny, go ahead.
This is so bullshit.
Yeah, we said we're talking about like real life relationships. Tinder and Bumble, that's not real life. That's like online interactions. Like
real
life interactions
with
people.
Relationships.
And
real
just
life
like
interaction.
Cinderella says, you see that on Instagram, it translates into the real life. You can't say that it's not real life because it is. We live on social media. You can't tell me that's not real life.
Wait, games.
So like trying to find somebody. Wait, let me respond. Trying to find somebody to have a relationship with in a real life environment is way different than
Destiny,
scrolling
it
through.
Destiny,
hold on, let Destiny finish. Canute, let him finish.
Let him finish.
You guys are all black-pilled as fuck. Holy shit. Like, Jesus Christ. Like, you're black-pilled. Black-pilled is when you think. So
nihilistic people is what you
let him finish. Hold on. Hey! Hey! Let him finish!
Oh my God.
But he's not fucking talking about the topic. He's talking about relationship. Yeah. They were talking about sex.
Canute, I've had enough of you! Let him finish!
There's a difference between talking about like
a bunch of different things.
The fact that you guys think the only place you can find sex is online apps is like
all
of your minds are. Yeah, if somebody's talking about like, well, how easy is it to find a partner to have sex or whatever, and you're like, well, the stats on Tinder and Bumble say this, that's not the only place you could find people to fuck. Firstly, Tinder and Bumble are like way different than like real life interactions. Like a girl's gonna get offered more dick on fucking Tinder or Bumble than she'll ever get in her entire life. Like walking, it's insane. And like,
doesn't that change your confidence?
For a guy,
Destiny, to get a bunch of random dicks in your inbox, does that really boost your confidence?
Yeah, but we didn't talk about confidence. You're going off topic again because we don't talk about confident pressure, anything. We're talking about where it was easiest to get laid for the fucking first time. That was the statement that Candy said, that he had to lower his standard. And girls didn't have to do that because they can get laid easier. We don't talk about getting a relationship with someone. We're not talking about having a good self-confidence. We're talking about walking out, asking a man,
Hold on, one second, Bastion.
Broadly strange. You're trying to run some social campaign here, like, let's change the way people view. Okay, great, dude. But we're just talking about, do people need to lower their standards to keep, like, to get laid more often? Which is where, what the fucking topic was. I don't know. I'm saying, literally,
if you feel like you don't visually mash up, then you'd probably want to go to some kind of forum in which you could emphasize some of your non-visual features for the purpose of trying to attract someone to you.
Visually,
people are attracted to more than just your face. Maybe not on not on Tinder, but maybe in other forums where you meet people.
This is something that, like, I like try to talk about a lot. Like, yeah, like, online interactions are meaningless, guys. Like, they don't, it's not anything like a real world interaction. Like, you can find people in the real world that if you had the opportunity to look at a Tinder profile, you'd swipe left every time. But when you meet them in person, you actually get along with them really well. People have used, like, online, like, either Tinder or Instagram or Discord to, like, replace all of their real life interactions.
And what's wrong with that?
Let him finish, John.
The problem is that they're not real. They're not the same. You don't know what a person is.
Hold on, Steven. You're telling me the girl I met on Club Pink that I've been talking to for 2 years straight is not real?
I'm saying that you don't know what that person is like. You might hang out with them and fucking hate them. Like, if you try meeting people in real life, you'll be surprised at the wide variety of people you get along with. Like, sure. I use this example all the time. Like, when you go to school, for instance, you're not matched in those classes based on 37 dimensions of personality. Those are just people that you're fucking thrown into class with. But somehow everybody ends up getting along for the most part as you go through school and high school.
I think that was a great closing point.
We should move on.
Destiny, you're equating two separate things.
Do in a professional setting because I know that everything is, it's a very safe environment. Safe environment to explore your sexuality.
How many dicks is too many dicks?
Excuse me, Wes, Jesus, how?
What's wrong with that question?
Like, you have to understand.
Look, I'm thinking about this, a gangbang.
I know, but I mean,
hold on, listen, Raj.
I just feel like you're just.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, five, because mouth, vagina, asshole, two hands.
Yeah,
that's all dicks cover.
So much.
Yeah.
But then after that, it's like,
oh my God, okay, Wes, stop with the DJ.
In the bottom two right now, the winner of the round is Mr. Destiny. God, you're just kicking ass, but Canute is closing in on you, Destiny. You better watch out. Canute's going for his first Raj Royale victory.
I've won.
Okay, that's right. You won probably because of your body, right, Canute?
Stop fucking harassing me. No, just kidding.
Okay, all right. Yeah. It's time, Destiny. You want a closing statement?
If I win, then we'll do a stream with Canute where we go sit him down at, like, some fucking insane SJW workshop where, like, seven, like, crazy blue-haired women can talk to him for an hour and talk to him about all those views or whatever. And he's not allowed, and if he raises his voice at any of them and gets frustrated or starts shouting, it's another 30
Holy
minutes
shit,
to sit there.
That's
he just won! He just
that is so fucking genius! Holy shit!
Oh, I lost!
Oh my God, okay. Don't worry.